students, it's the term 1 Java session. Students who have joined so far: Akshaya, Rahul, Ankit, Nandu, Chavi Kumar, Ankit, Manish, Pooja, Abhish, Kanchan, Mohit, Deepak, Siddharth, Sonu, Vaibhav, Sindasini, Gulshan, Pankaj, Shiv, Yash, Sinang, Sunep, Ashit, Yogita, Brandon, Hussein, Mansi, Rid, Shubham, Vishnu, Mizbah, Surbhi, Ankit, Anindita, Devajiti. Students who are joining with guest IDs, let me tell you, for me, I don't know your names, na? So when the people from head office, when somebody is asking me whether this student is there in a batch or not, I'm saying no. Because I have no track, I have no record of your name. You know, those of you are attending with, guest IDs, please go and tell your center that from SLT, ma'am has said that because we are logging in with guest IDs, ma'am does not have any tracking of our existence. Okay, please go and tell it. Others I have told, okay, there are many students who are irregular in this batch. I mean, either they are absent or they log in late, log out early, something like that. So for them also I have marked absent. Sorry. Okay. One important thing is coming up for you in the coming week. What is that? Something very important is coming up for you in the coming week. What is that? What is that? Yes, Mohit, Chavi, Shubham. Yeah, Amish, you're present, I've seen you. Yes, Rahul. Pooja, cloud consultation anyway I will take in the coming week for your doubt clarification. That is not a problem. Which exam, Anindita? Which exam is coming up? So it seems only Shubham, Chavi, Mohit, Rahul, only these people are aware of NITstudent.com. Only they are sincere enough to check their NITstudent.com about their appraisals, when is their cycle test, CMR, exam. Yeah, Anindita, correct. Yes, so your PMR is coming up. When is your PMR? When is your PMR? When is your PMR? Abhish, If you're a student of 842, when is your PMR? 842. Anindita, right. Shubham, right. Pankaj, right. Rahul, right. No, Chavi. For which batch, Abhisht? For which batch it is showing 15th? Because I have set the PMR on 13th. I don't know if somebody has changed after that. In my system it is 13th. For 842. If you are 963, Abhisht, I don't know. 963 schedule I don't have. That I cannot change or any. I don't have any control over that. I'll just... If you, no, 832 is 13th. Give me your ID password. All of you open your nitestream.com and tell me when is your next PMR. Yes, Pankaj, correct. Okay, Abhish, hold on, don't type anything else. Let me open NITstudent.com with Abhish. Details. PMR. Don't type anything else, Abhish. Let me take your student ID. That's what I'm saying. Let me check. And Abhish is also saying for 15. I have marked it as 13th. So I don't know if somebody has changed it. My network is pretty slow, so it's loading the page. Meanwhile, let me check my system also. Yes, Ashish, that's what I'm checking because I have given the PMR date as 13th. That's what I'm checking, that what went wrong. This page is also not opening. What about the cycle test? All of you have attempted all the cycle tests so far? Brandon Sunep, Yogita Mansi, I think you are from a different batch, that's why. But otherwise, I think everybody has given. I mean, by now, at least the previous week, cycle test is given. All of you, please log out from student.com once and log in again and tell me what is the date showing, because I have given 13. I made the previous cycle also, cycle test also, I have checked the date. It is not submitted, I guess that's why it is showing or reflecting a wrong data. Now I have submitted it. Can you please check and tell me? Can you please tell me? So Chavi, you are saying, but then it is showing 13 in my system. I don't know why you are having that data, Chavi. In my system, it is showing 13. February 2017. Rahul is also saying 13. Kumar Ankit saying 13. Shubham saying 13. Vishnu saying 13. Your page is not yet open. Let me show you. Avisht, if you can see, your page is still loading. I'm not able to check from your login. So I'm going to cancel this. And you check it from your login, Avisht, and tell me what it is reflecting right now. Anindita is also saying 13. Chavi and Avisht, can you please tell me now what it is showing? Pavi and Abhisht, can you recheck? Wow, Mohit, check it right now. Right now it is showing 13. Okay, wait, Abhisht, your login has opened, finally. Yes. So see, TMR on 13th, cycle test on 16th. TMR 13th, cycle test on 16th. It's not showing, this is for batch 842. This is Abhisht's login. So Chavi and Mohit, can you please check again? For others, it is reflecting as 13th. 13th CMR, 16th cycle test. Yeah, Mohit is saying 13. Savi, what about you? Ashit Das is saying 13. Savi, what about you? That means for everybody it is showing 13th. So 16th PMR, sorry, 13th PMR, 16th cycle test. Is that over for everybody? PMR 13, 16th cycle test. Cycle test 5 on 16th, PMR on 13th. Has everybody registered this? Akshaya, Rahul, Ankit, Nandu, Suryamugam, Chavi, Kumarankit, Manish, Pooja, Yogesh, I don't know whether Yogesh you are from this batch or not. Abhish, Kanchan, Mohit, Deepak, Siddharth, Sonu, Vaibhav, Bindasani, Ankit, Gulshan, Pankaj, Sheetal, Shiv, Yash, Varanam, Sunev, Devanshu, Ashit, Dharmendra, Yogita, you are from different batch, Brandon, Hussain, Mansi, Rich, Shivam, Shlok, Shubham, Vishnu, Komal, Rahul, Mizbah, Surbhi, Ankit, Anindita, Devajati and guest IDs I cannot say. Is it clear to everybody about your PMR and cycle test? Okay. Anybody who is having any problem with MR practical, anybody who is not getting a practical support at center, your software not there, faculty not there, any problem you are facing, anybody, it should not be the case. I mean, I'm sure everybody is getting that support from center. I'm just checking because I got some information from other batches, so I was just checking if anybody has any problem regarding any practical, any MR at center, anybody. Please respond in the raise hand. Okay. Okay, then I believe all of you have completed till NIO practical. Now what we move on, if not NIO, at least till IO practical you have done. Now what we do, we move on to this, new topic, new chapter, which is called threading. Now, before I start explaining threading, let me tell you, there's a term which is frequently used in respect to modern day computers, which is called multitasking. Any idea what this multitasking means? Any idea what this multitasking means? Yes, Rahul, Akshaya, some. Yes, correct. Any idea what multitasking means? Yes, Shubham, very correct. Okay, Anindita, lots of work doing at the same time. Brandon says, doing many tasks at a time. Savi says, you can deal with many work. Suzy says, performing multiple tasks at the same time. Reed also says the same. Ashit says the same. Ms. Bash, Shubham, Vishnu says the same. Some guest student is also doing the same. Okay. So, many of you have that basic idea of what multitasking is, which means something or somebody has the capability of doing मल्टीपल टास्क एट द सेम टाइम. सो मैंने किया कंप्यूटर इज मल्टीटास्किंग. कंप्यूटर व्हाट डू यू रेफर टू? हु इज डूइंग दैट मल्टीपल टास्क एट द सेम टाइम? व्हाट इज दैट दैट थिंग? Yes, Ridge. Correct. Absolutely. Yes, rest of you. What is that thing who is actually doing multitasking? No, Andheri gets to then no. I am asking that in modern day computer, even if you are not learning Java, forget that you have learned Java. No, normally. Yes, Akshaya, correct. Rahul, correct. Somebody else also answered. Yes, correct. Somebody else also answered. When I say that this computer is a multitasking computer, so which part of this computer is actually doing that multitask? Nandang Sunep, correct. Mohit, wrong. Rahul, wrong. Ashit, correct. Subham, correct. Surbhi incorrect, Hussain correct, Sheetal correct, Rahul correct, guest students I cannot name, but guest students correct, Chavi correct, sorry not Chavi, Shivam correct, Chavi incorrect, no Suryam Mugam. See, even now you have a doubt of what is a RAM and what is a CPU. After taking so many cloud consultations, so many classes on hash code, you know, if I remember in the cloud consultation of hash code or the cloud consultation, you know, the prolonged cloud consultation where I was teaching so many things, additional things, I have, clearly explained what is RAM and what is the work of RAM and what is the work of CPU. Tell me, does RAM perform any task? Tell me this, does RAM perform any task? Now Shubham is saying no. Ridge, no. Rahul, no. Ashit, no. Chavi, you are saying no. Yes, Andheri, correct. Yes, Nandush, correct. Yeah, correct. I mean, RAM does not perform any task. RAM is there to provide you that location, that space. Remember, I was giving you, I think I was explaining some student about a classroom and me being the professor and the classroom being the RAM, and I'm using the RAM, I'm using the classroom temporarily, I'm using that space to, you know, do my work. I need a space to do my work, so professor is actually doing the task, but professor needs a space to do the task. So professor is doing the task inside the RAM. Okay. So when I say that multitasking, it is done by the CPU, the central processing unit. Okay? Whiteboard? Yes, Shivam, correct. So now, if this is my CPU, what are the two major parts of CPU? What are the two major parts of CPU? No. Ashit correct. Rahul from Kalyan incorrect. Shubham incorrect. Reed incorrect. Guest one Andheri correct. Bendan Sunep incorrect. Rahul from Komangla correct. Nandurani, I am saying CPU is the processor, Babu. CPU is the processor. Central processing unit is the processor. This comes in a microchip. If you open the system unit, you will find there is a small chip. Usually, I mean, if you are taking a branded computer, you will be finding the CPU belongs to Intel. So that's a very small micro size chip. So that's why it's called micro processor. So in short, we call it as processor. CPU is the processor. Yes, content heavy. Raj, now you're correct. So we have two parts of CPU, ALU and CU. What is the full form of ALU and what is the full form of CU? What is ALU and what is CU? Yes, Akshaya from Kormangla, correct. Ankit, correct. Vishnu, correct. Ashit, correct. Shubham, correct. Mohit, correct. Ridge, correct. Andheri guest student, correct. Surbhi, correct. Rahul Kormangla, correct. Good, very good. So, ALU stands for Arithmetic Logic Unit. And CU stands for Control Unit. So this is taking care of all the computation, all the operation, all the, you know, calculation. And CU controls sequence of execution. Okay, ALU does the computation, CU does the sequence of execution. Ideally, if I am writing a program, class A, which has two methods, class B, which again has the main method and some other method. Okay, suppose there are two classes. When you submit this entire program to the Java C and then to the JVM, JVM automatically picks up the main method first. Java C also picks up the main method first. And then it goes to JVM. JVM picks up this bytecode and whatever and sends it to the ALU. And CU will decide that out of this, this will be executed first or this one or this one. Main method it cannot touch because by default main method is the main thread. It will always be executed first. But apart from main method, which method will be executed in which sequence, that control is done by control unit. And the actual operation, whatever is written inside the bodies of these methods, that those operations are done by ALU. Okay? Now there are three methods. Okay? What will JVM do? Can JVM send all three of them together? Can JVM send all three of them together? Can JVM send all three of them together? Answer me. Chavir says no. Vic says no question mark. Okay. Nandu saying yes. Okay. What about the rest? Can JVM send it at the same time to the ALU? Akshay says no. अक्षया फ्रॉम कोरमंगला. कैन आई स्पीक? आशित सेज नो. राहुल फ्रॉम कल्याण सेज यस. As long as this method is, this program is a normal program, JVM will not be able to send it to the ALU all at the same time. CU will decide that which one to take first, which one to take next, which one to take third. CU will decide that. Okay? JVM cannot override it and send all the three methods at the same time to ALU, because ALU logically one ALU can logically perform one task at one time. One ALU doing task one at a given time. This is logically possible. So two tasks it cannot use. JVM cannot send task two, task three to ALU. Okay? Right? But what is the problem? When ALU is executing this CALC, rest of the two methods are waiting. After this entire execution is over, then maybe this one is sent to ALU. Again, when this one is getting executed, the first one is again waiting for 3, 5, 3, 4 seconds. After this completely gets executed, then the third method is sent to ALU. Right? So, logically speaking, the wait time, which is bared by the rest of the two methods, can be distributed among all three of them in such a way so that none of the threads are waiting for too long. Okay? Without any execution. None of the threads are waiting for too long without any execution. So that means, let's say there is a person who is a gift. Wrapper person, okay? He wraps up gifts, okay? So there are three people standing for wrapping up of gifts, okay? This person has three gifts, this person has two, this person has three, okay? What will this person do? It will take the first packet, wrap it, come to the second person, take the second packet, wrap it, go to the third person, take this packet, wrap it, come back to the first person, take the second packet, wrap it, come back to the second person, take the second packet, wrap it, go to the third person, take the second packet, wrap it, go to the first person again, take the third packet, wrap it, again go to the third person, take the third packet, wrap it. So, though the total time is same, yet no user is static continuously. No user will be able to say that, okay, I'm not going to wait because I'm waiting for too long and none of my work is in progress. Nobody can complain that. Why? because this person has also got one packet wrapped, this person has also got one packet wrapped, this person has also got one packet wrapped. In the next round, again, next one. So, it is equally sharing the time and dividing the time amongst all the people. Okay? Are you getting this? So, none of them are waiting for too long without getting processed. It is not that they are not attended. This nice person is attending to all the three people. Okay? And the person is so fast that when the person is wrapping somebody else's gift, the other person is busy collecting his or her wrapped gift. Okay? So though the person knows that this wrapper is wrapping somebody else's work, still the person is ready to wait because he can see that the work is in progress. This person has already wrapped one package for him and will come back and do it again very soon. So that means the same time, but it is distributed in such a way between these three people that none of them are feeling unattended. Same thing happens in thread. Okay? You have a task one, task two, and task three, and here you have the CPU. Okay, so now CPU scheduler, what will it do? CPU scheduler, which is there in control unit, it will take up this first task, second task, third task. Okay? First task is of 4 kilobytes. Second task, 6 kilobytes. Third task, 3 kilobytes. So what will CPU do? It will go to task 3 first. Complete 1 KB, go to first task, complete 1 KB or 2 KBs, whatever, go to task 2, complete 2 KB, come back to task 3, complete another 1 KB, again go to task 1, complete another 1 KB, this is 1 KB, 1 KB, 1 KB, 1 KB, 2 KBs, 2 KBs, again come back here, third task, again complete the last portion, goes back to task 1, completes 2 KB, comes to task 3, completes the rest. Okay? No, it is not ordered. It is randomly done by CPU scheduler. You, me, we cannot manually choose the task. Okay? We cannot do that. Please tell me if you have a doubt. Anybody has any doubt so far? How the CPU scheduler is distributing the same time by doing partial execution of each thread each time? sorry, after each task is each time. It's not ideal state, it is idle state. I-D-O-L, Ashit. But this scenario is only possible when each method is converted into thread. That is only possible if you inherit from the thread class or the runnable class and use the object to call the method. So when method is converted into the thread, which means the class has to be the thread object, and each method will be each task of the thread. So in that case, this is only possible. Okay? So the moment you convert your program, normal program, into thread program, that moment JVM does this. It can manage thread. Thread management in Java is done by JVM. So it will manage all this conversion of normal thread into normal method into thread method and thread object, and how they will be converted into objects, and what will be the life cycle. Okay, I am telling you the life cycle. Even the life cycle is done by JVM. Anybody has any query so far? Very feeble response in the raise hands. Either all of you are understanding or none of you are understanding. This diagram is absolutely clear. Out of 50 students, only 14 students have replied so far. 15 students have replied. You know, this scenario is exactly like a yes or no. Or, you know, it has got different names in different parts of India. All of them are doing the same thing, just like this. Isn't it? All of them are doing the same thing with their customers, because they have multiple customer requests at the same time. They cannot make their customers wait for too long. Ultimately, all the customers are waiting for the same time. Customer 1 is also waiting 5 minutes, customer 2 is also waiting 5 minutes. But within those 5 minutes, in each minute, customer 1 is getting 1 Golgappa, customer 2 is getting 1 Golgappa. Again, in the next minute, customer 1 getting 1 Golgappa, customer 2 getting 2nd Golgappa. Yes, no? Only Sheetal, Ashita and Savi is saying yes. I don't know, rest of you are, whether you are listening or not listening. Misbah, are you listening? I have never got a reply from Misbah. I have got very rare reply from Shlok. From कोमल निस्बा श्लोक कोमल। I've got very less reply from Bendang Sunep. Okay, that's great. So after this diagram, okay, a question will come into your mind that even if for 5 seconds or 0.5 seconds one task is going on, at that time, at that 0.5 time, the rest of the two tasks are idle, they are not processing, okay, but they are also not static. I mean, it's not that they have not even initiated. They have been initiated, a portion of them have been executed, but they are currently for that 0.5 second where this task is going on, the other two are waiting. So you will say that then how can it be multitasking? But let me tell you, let's say your thread one is music, your thread 2 is typing, and your thread 3 is downloading. Your computer can do all these things at the same time. You can switch on your VLC player to play a music, and you can open your MS Word to type, and at the same time you can be downloading some image. You can do all these three tasks at the same time in your machine. You will see that the download is going on, whatever you are typing, it is coming on the screen, and also in the back end the music is playing. No, already the time interval is not constant. Everything is dynamically and randomly fixed by CPU schedulers. Okay, so all these three things are done by the computer. Can you make any difference? Basically, when although all these three things are going on in the back end, your music is basically stopping for 500 milliseconds. Your typing is stopping for 600 milliseconds. Download is stopping for 900 milliseconds, which means less than a second. 1000 milliseconds is 1 second. So less than 1 second time is paused in each of the tasks at various times. Not at the same time. At the same time, all three of them will not stop. When music is playing, typing is stopped for 600 milliseconds. Download is stopped for 900 milliseconds. And typing again after 500 milliseconds, typing is started. Then download is still in pause, then typing is stopped, download starts, music and typing is paused. So like that they are all kept in pauses. But do you feel the difference? Have you ever felt that suddenly the music is stopping after every half of a second? No. This is the too much. I mean, it is not even half of a second. Basically it is 50 milliseconds, 90 milliseconds, something like that. So the interval for which the thread has to stop is so minor that the difference is negligible and it is not decipherable by the human ear or human eye or human perseverance power. Human will not be able to understand this difference because the difference of time is so fractional. Okay? Respond in the raise hand, okay? Then only I will move on and explain the next thing. Now let's go to the. So now all of you are clear what is thread? How can we make a thread or what is referred to as thread in Java programming? Now we move to this thread lifecycle. Let me tell you, this process where the threads are executed partially one after the another, this is called a synchronous process. Okay, remember this word, you will require this in the next chapter also. Second, all of you? Okay. Next is thread lifecycle. Okay, so this is a life cycle where a thread is first created. It has to be started by the start method. Okay, then it is in a runnable state. From runnable state, you have to start running it by the run method. From the run method, from the running state, it can go back to not runnable state by either calling sleep method or pause method or wait method or suspend method. And from not runnable, it can again go back to runnable state by either a normal timeout number of seconds or by calling interrupt method or notify method or resume method. Or from not runnable, it can directly be terminated through abort method. okay? Can you take down the, don't take a picture, just note it down in a page. Don't take a picture. Note this down in a page. All of you, notify. After interrupt, it is notify. Ashit. Notify. After pause, wait, WAIT, wait method or suspend method. Wait method or suspend method. Terminated from not runnable, it can be terminated by abort method. And from running, it can go to not runnable by pause, wait or suspend method or sleep method. Four methods for not runnable. Running to not runnable, four methods: sleep, pause, wait, suspend. First is new method. After that, when the new thread is created, after that you have to start it. From runnable state, you have to make it into running by run method. After running, it can go to not runnable by either sleep or pause or wait or suspend. Or from running, it can be completed. Over. Now from not runnable, if it is terminated, it will be abort. And from not runnable, if it is going back to runnable state, it will be either because of timeout or interrupt or notify or resume method. Clear, all of you? Only 14 students have replied out of 50 students. What is the problem in typing three words, three letters yes or four letters D O N E done? If you have taken it down, what is the problem in saying done? Fifteen students. एनीवे लेट अस नाउ स्टार्ट विथ नेटबीन्स। And see your threading coding. I will share the thread coding and NIO coding together. I mean, I will do it on Saturday. So now I will create a new project. Setting example. I don't need the main method. I'll just create the class and create the main methods myself. So this is my threading example project. Inside that source package, on the default package, right click, new Java package, threading. Inside threading, new Java class, always remember something. I'm writing it in comments. By default, always main method is the main thread. You cannot change it. It will always be called first. It is the highest priority thread. Okay, Shivam, let me show this code. After that, I'll give you a break. It will just take 5 minutes. Just give me 5 minutes. Okay. Next thing. A thread class must inherit. Sorry. A class must inherit the thread class or runnable interface to become a thread object. Okay? Commonly used constructors of thread class which we are using will be all of you are taking this down. Thread constructor. Thread with string name, runnable R. runnable R object and the string name. So these are all constructor overloading. Okay. Now I will start the coding. Public class child study example. Okay. So if I want to convert this child thread example into a thread object, what do I have to do? One more important thing, run method is in thread class, which is the parent class, predefined class, which has to be overridden. Okay, now tell me, what do? I will write extend, because I have to inherit from the thread class. I will write extend thread. Okay, in the class I will override the method run, public void run. So method name will be run, the predefined method, but body I will override. And what will I write in the body? Let's say I'm taking two threads. So for int I equals to 1, I less than 5 or 4, I plus plus, thread T equals to thread dot current thread, system dot out dot println T dot get name, it will get the name of the thread. Okay. Now after this class is over, this method is over, run method, I'll write the main method, public void main. Main method is the main thread. Public static void main. Child thread ex ob1 equals to new child thread ex, and same thing 2. So that means 2 threads will be created. Okay. First thread I will name it as child thread 1 and second thread I will name it as child thread 2. Then system dot out dot println Obi-Wan dot is alive. You're checking whether the thread is in alive or not. It has been put into a runnable state or not. You're checking. These are all predefined method. I will give you the list of the methods in your cloud group. Though it is there in the book, but I'll give you all 15, 22 methods which are there in thread class. Okay? So, now you write Obi-Wan dot start. After that, so you write this together, system.out.println, obi1.alive, obi2.isalive or not. Both the objects are alive or not, you are checking. Then you write obi2.start, obi1.start, and then again you check whether it is alive or not. Okay? Before starting, you are checking whether it is alive or not. After starting, you are checking whether it is alive or not. Okay? Now you run this program. Each thread will go for three times. 1, 2, 3, less than 4. So each thread will go 3 times. So see, first you have written OB1 is alive, OB2 is alive, it is showing false. First two result is false, next two result is true. Why? Because between the first output and the second output, you have started the thread. So first, before the start method, it is showing false, but after the start method, it is showing true. After it is in true state, it is alive, then it will call the object OB1 and OB2. OB1 is also referring this class. OB2 is also referring this class. So when OB1 is referring this class, inside this class, the thread object is called and printed for 3 times from 1, 2, 3 and the name is displayed. Again it comes to the main method and OB2 is created. OB2 is started. So after OB2 is started, again this child thread EX method is invoked, class object is invoked. Inside that run method is invoked and with the run method again thread object T is created and it is displayed 3 times, but this time it will get the name of the second child thread 2. So that's what it is displaying. Is it clear, all of you? Only 5 students are saying yes, it is clear. What about the rest? You don't have to write the code. I will share everything in the group. Don't worry, Abhish. I will share both NIO code and this code. I'll share the entire package in your cloud group by this weekend. Camera, please. Okay, so let's go for a short break and within that break I will post all the methods which is there in thread class in your cloud group so that you can come back from the break and check the methods. Okay, Mohit, are you trying to say anything? Screen is chicken. Mohit from 3DR, what are you saying? I'm connecting to you. Tell me. Say, Mohit, you're on air. Say, Mohit, you're on air. Speak. Don't type. Speak. Speak. Unmute your mic and speak. Unmute. It is not unmuted. There is no option of mute. What text phone? Okay, type. Quickly type. Both, NIO. Last class I have done NIO, right? NIO and today's threading. All the codes I will put it in a zip folder and I'll upload in your cloud book by this weekend. And next weekend I'll take a cloud consultation. That was clearly. Okay. Thank you, Mohit. We can go for a break. Everyone back? Check your cloud group, all of you. Check your cloud group, all of you. All these methods that I've used, you'll see that those methods and their explanation, I've given it in your cloud group. You have to search page by page, Rahul. I upload the codes. You have to search page by page. All of you have got the codes, the methods. I cannot show you how your login is not with me. Open your cloud group and see in the page wherever you see a zip file, upload my post where I have posted. If there is any upload, click on that upload, it will download and do that. How can I do it from here? Got it? Chavi is saying got it. Okay, rest of them are also got it. Has everybody got it? The methods and its definition. Akshay is saying got it. I am trying to upload one document right now. Just check if you are getting those. I am trying to upload IO, NIO and today's threading. So Rahul, you can check it right now if the latest update you are getting. That will be the topmost post on your wall. I think everybody has got that. Meanwhile, no, Rahul, then your internet is not working correctly. Everybody else have got it. Okay, Rahul, I have given a post right now. Because Mohit was also asking about the 2nd February's work. So I have uploaded IO, NIO as well as today's work. IO was 2nd February, NIO was this Tuesday and today was threading. So I've uploaded all three of them together. Mohit, you also check and confirm, and Rahul, you also check and confirm. Rahul, you also get a check and confirm. The latest post that I've done just now are the codes. Okay? Meanwhile, we can have the end of session questions. Latest post that I've done Rahul and Mohit. Mohit, I think you were asking about the 2nd Feb. So just check and confirm. 3 zip files I have uploaded. NIO, IO and threading. Jyoti has got all the posts. Okay. Ashit, you come out of the nidstudent.com and again log in and check. Rest of you also check. 3 zip files. And I have also written in the heading of the post. Shavi has also got the files, all the zip files. Rahul from Kormangla has got. All of you have got it? Menang Suneb got it from Dimapur. Pune Kharadi. Everybody is getting it. I just want a confirmation from Rahul Kalyan Center and Mohit from PGR, I guess. Mohit was mailing me regarding this. Mohit and Rahul, if you can confirm. Okay, Ashif has also got it. Yeah, so everybody gave it. It's the latest post that I have done. Okay? So, all the best for your PMR. Your PMR will be before we meet again. And make sure that you practice all the codes, go through every line of the book. We will again meet on coming Tuesday and then you will go for the cycle test and coming weekend, like Friday or Saturday of coming week, I will be taking your cloud consultation again for your doubt clarification, okay? Your exam is approaching, let me tell you, your exam will be either on 5th March or 11th March, something like that. It will be very, very soon. So please, you know, yeah, 11th or 10th March is your exam. So please be ready, please practice. All the best for your PMR. Don't leave out any questions in the PMR. Do the steps properly. You will get step marking if you are correct to a certain point of, you know, step. Okay? Please inform your faculty today itself that you have a PMR on Monday from this time to this time. And be in the center before the time. Monday, this time to this time, you have a PMR. Inform your local faculty today itself. Okay? Thank you, everyone. All the best for your PMR. See you next week. We can end the session.